Let us pray. O God, you have set a limit to this present life so as to open up an entry into eternity. We beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant, Vupekabwe, to be inscribed in the book of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. We may be seated as we have the first reading.
Something that is going to be transient, or the power that is going to be temporal, or the money that church, we give our tithes, we help the poor, we reach out. Basically, we are good people. And when tragedy comes, we feel like God has forsaken us. God has failed us. And if we are not strong, sometimes we can be a little bit Jesus Christ. And that is why we need to have a And that is when we encounter difficulties, when we encounter tragedy, I think at the end of the tragedy, we are not going to find the answer why we were going through that. But as Christians, we hope and pray that we are going to encounter Jesus in our difficulties. Yesterday, for those of you who are Catholics, when we went to church, the first reading was from Job, and we asked God, he said, these days are all empty. What is this? God did not answer Job why he was going through the difficulties. Instead, God posed more questions to Job, and Job found out that he wasn't significant, he wasn't the center of attention, that at the end of the day, what happened is Job encountered God. When we suffer, when we encounter God, we are no longer the same. Our sister believed in Jesus Christ. She trusted Jesus Christ. She knew Jesus Christ is the God of God. And if Jesus Christ has put that to herself, she said, I don't know. And that's what our lives are telling you, what's going on in that. Sometimes you hear people say, maybe
Pray for mum. And we thank the Lord for the wonderful, joyous years we shared. The Lord has called her my best friend. And we take comfort in the fact she's lived her life to the fullest and her faith never wavered. May she continue to watch over us, inspire us, and, as was part of her nature, welcome us with generosity and open arms when our time comes and we meet again. God, hear us.
Thank you, Mom, for your dear, sweet love. The love you gave each of your children, son-in-law, daughters-in-law, and grandchildren was like no other. It was the perfect blend of strength, understanding, warmth, inspiration, and most of all, enjoyment. And as you loved us this way, you loved your friends and family as peers. What force you have been in this world. We pray for all who mourn. May our tears be wiped away. And may our morning turn into what you brought us each and every day. So, Lord, hear us. We pray for those who care for the sick and housebound. We give thanks for the skills and the commitment of doctors, nurses, and carers. May they continue to reflect compassion and healing of God who is made known to us in Christ. Lord, hear us.
Auntie, who may live in Christ's commandment of love, may she now hear those words. Come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Lord, hear us.
Lord Jesus, you who is the life of the resurrection, to bring our troubled hearts to you. May you accompany us and may you be with us. We ask for you to receive this child that you have expressed here and those that I did not meet of our hearts. For we make them to Christ our Lord. Amen.
The simple gifts of bread and wine to be transformed into the body and blood of Jesus Christ, the way, the resurrection, the truth, and the life are now ready. So pray with me, dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be near, O Lord, we pray to your servant, Vupekabwe, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to her, or any human fault have affected her, it may by your loving gift be forgiven and wiped away. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that though saddened by the certainty of dying, might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, as an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with the whole host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. His Lord, for his Lord, his Lord is risen from the dead, and his Lord is Lord, every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, our spouse, the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we derive unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Patrick, our Bishop, the Order of Bishop, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Bupekawe, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth you raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you wipe away every tear from our eyes, for seeing you, our God, as you are. We shall be like you for all ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
For it is through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And now we stand and pray the prayer our Lord Jesus Christ left us, as together we say, Our Father. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. As we grapple with these difficult times, one of the things that we realize is there is not so much peace in the world. Peace from the coronavirus, peace in war-torn countries, peace everywhere where people refuse to be reconciled to one another, and lack of peace for losing a loved one. And so we call on Jesus Christ, who's the Prince of Peace, so that his peace, the peace beyond all understanding, beyond all doubt, will come to us as we say, Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. O Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God, behold Jesus Christ our brother, the way, the truth, the life, and the resurrection. It is him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
Your rest after toil, O Lord, life after death, grant eternal rest. We now pray in thanksgiving. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant, Wupekabwe, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
At this time, I would like to call upon the family representative to give the life history to come, and also the one who's giving the church history. And then we'll go with the final commendation, and we'll let you know what next we are going to do.
From which she never tired,
and for that we thank her for keeping her welfare. That being said, she did have a unique self-approach. Often chickens were delivered in batches of 10, 15, or 20 to buyers, or before they had actually even placed an order. And mind you, if you didn't pay on time, she'll diplomatically say something that reminds you that it's 2 hours away, and don't agree to pay before the time the money comes. She was very particular. She made her husband marry his son in the day 70 before marriage on the 12th May 1973. She was a true union of love based on their shared values of hard work, respect, companion, honesty, fun, kindness, and humility. She went on to have 4 children, more piano, so like I said, and her only daughter Camila, to whom they instilled these same values, which provided for them the strong foundations for their own life. She is survived by 4 children and 8 grandchildren. And throughout her illness, she always talks of when she gets better, she's going to go and see her grandchildren, whom she will miss so much. She kept on saying, boy, can I find a woman? Find a boy. They have to manage to write. I say, boy, nobody will go out. But alas, never came. But daughters, they had to come around, she did not make it through. We enjoy the company. We will miss her. For me, Lusaka will be the same. Without her, because she's always made me laugh. Even when I'm crying, she just said, for me, she just look at me and said, oh, you got it, baby. You got the child, you see, you got the little one, right? We will not be the final one. It's just, oh, you know, what do you do? You just say, oh, it. Anyway, that's the life of this kind of my dear friend, Boy Wadi. She will be missed, but she has fought her good fight. She has finished the race and kept the faith. They are so rest in the of children, we are very grateful for what that boy man. And she was very proud of her. Now, if you see the children, my old people are coming in the park. You did your best, but God bless you. Thank you.
And that was not unusual because our community is very diverse. We have a membership that spans from the whole of the Saka province. It even includes people in the diaspora. 5 weeks ago, she called me and said, So what I'm going to do, as I go for my review at Megan, I'll drop the money at your home so that you pay for me. That is how it is sure. We shall miss our dear sister. Rest in peace till we meet again. In baptism, Mrs. Rebecca will receive the sign of the cross. May she now share in the Christ's victory over sin and death. Thank you.
walk away in the sure and certain hope that together we are made in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Mrs. Calvary in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us, who remain, to comfort one another with assurance of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Loving mother, caring daughter, cherished sister and loyal friend. Perhaps, though, our proudest honor was that of grandma, or more aptly, Nana B. She was ever so proud of Charity, Tama, Sonda, Michael, Jaya, Leah, Isaac, and Isabella, Bella B, named after her. She beamed with pride when she heard and saw their accomplishments, and cherished every moment that she spent with them. Her heart filled with joy when she heard their voices calling out, "Hi, Nana B," or "Hi, Grandma." It was this same joy that resonated when one of us children would call affectionately, "Mom, Mommy, and my Mommy," or in Campbell's case, "You." Through hard work, perseverance, and determination, she and Dad ensured we had many opportunities as well as demonstrating how endurance and spirit is in the rewards. Mom was a queen amongst women. Our family and you. She was carried by her faith and belief in the Lord. This was the cornerstone of her life and helped her through the health challenges of these past 18 months. She was an inspiration throughout our lives, and this was further shown and exceeded during our illness. A joyful, inviting, kind-spirited, and warm, embracing personality never wavered. Never allowed the spirit to burden her anyone else that knew her. She epitomized optimism, strength, hope, and defiance. Indicative of this defiance was her reminding us over the past few months that she would be turning 70 this year and expected a surprise birthday party. Don't worry, I'll act surprised on the day, she would say. We may not have the opportunity to surprise her this August 1st, but we know in heaven, on February 3rd, there was a party far greater than the punch where they hosted for her, as she was welcomed home by her soulmate Dad and all our dear departed. How fortunate we are to have had her as our mom. Her intelligence, determination, hard work, and life experiences gained for more recoveries. What characteristics she loved to share. She knew how to connect with each of us in her own special way, developing unique bonds, not just with us, but with our spouse, whom she embraced and loved just as dearly. She knew what we required and what we needed, a laugh, a hug, a smile, and even a telephone from time to time were all part of her love for us. No matter where we lived, she worked to remain a constant in our lives, enjoying her retirement life as an avid globetrotter. Visits to the UK, America, Jamaica, Spain, Germany, and others were not just holidays for her, but an indication of her commitment to her children and grandchildren. An indelible mark will forever remain engraved within us, and all in the pleasure of meeting her. Morphe, you carry our desire within you, sense of well-meaning, compassion, and love for family and the community. Kasasi, you carry our joyful, fun-loving, and dancing abilities, as well as a positiveness, leadership, and sense of humor. Tamwole, you show us the brightness of her spirit, reflecting her warm motherly instincts and actions, her self-assuredness, beauty, and the honesty that only mom could bring. We can turn to each other to receive a dose of her, as well as a reminder of what she meant to us. Mom, on behalf of Mafia, Eric, Musunga, Anna, Sase, Ennis, Kambole, and Zamar, we say thank you for raising us. For your outpouring love and support far greater than you could have ever asked. You are true blessings from God, and we thank you for sharing them with us. May you rest today peacefully knowing that your work here is complete. Love your children. I also have the pleasure of sharing words of tribute written by some of my grandchildren. These first words come from Charity Town. He said, "Feel no guilt in anger, she knows how much you care. Feel no sorrow in a smile that she's not here to share. Cannot be forever. She would not want you to. She hoped you could carry on the way you always do. So talk about the good times and the way you showed you care. The days you spent together or the happiness you shared. The memories around you are words someone can say who suddenly recapture a time, an hour, a day. That brings her back as clearly as though she was here. Fills you with the feeling that she is always me. If you keep these moments, you will never be apart. She will forever be locked safe within your heart." The next words come from Tamaka. "Grandma, who's always so real to me, she always wanted what was best for me and wanted me to enjoy whatever moment you were in. I remember specifically when we went to visit. I was tired of walking around and not being able to go on as many rides as I hoped. And she looked at me and said, 'Smile, Chama, you're at Disney.' Or if we're ever taking photos, she would say, 'Smile, Chama, your smile will make the picture much better.' Or Dad, if you took pictures of me and Michael to send to her, she would pour and ask me why I wasn't smiling as big, for one minute. Pretty white teeth were not showing. She always wanted me to smile and be happy, and with her around, it was never hard for me. And I'm going to miss her always, looking out for my smile and being so happy. Michael, I'd like to share these words. Grandma, very selfish, and loved us all. She would want us to live for others and live for her. And lastly, Leah, wanted to say this. I pray that Nana B is happy in heaven with the two grandmothers. Love you, Nana B. Love you.
And gentlemen, there is something that Usunga didn't confess. That the mother used to call the children collectively in a long way. May I now invite Mrs. Linda and the government in the church for the young people. Has left an incredible mark on our lives and that of many.
we knew when someone spoke to us and asked, how is your sister? We knew immediately your sister, they were talking about. And it will always be like that. And that will be followed by an encounter of some humorous events that we are trying to have and will share with her. Her presence was always felt. And her presence will remain with us always. You could count on Madam Mushia's honest opinion. When everyone in the room was seeing that something needs to say there, but not everyone was scared to say it, trust that Madam Mushia would come up and say it. And that will resolve an issue, and there will be laughter and peace. She never held things to her heart. She said it and forgot about it and life went on. That was Madam Mushia. She endeavored to be the best from the way she dressed. I'm sure you'll be following the pictures. And those who know her know about Madam Mushia. Her surroundings, her beautiful gardens. In whatever she did it with her own heart. And she made sure that what she started, she accomplished. She loved fun. She loved to have fun. And she loved unconditionally. I don't know if people understand the unconditional love that it appears in our Bibles. That's what Madam Mushia had. And she made everybody feel special in a special way. She did her business with zeal. We are going to talk about the fear of the Irish Chamber. Anything else that she did, leisure, she made sure that she had all the T's and dots collected, and people would come and have fun. She loved shopping, and she loved her games. Recently, while she was already sick, I went to visit her, and we had some business discussion with colleagues. And in my mind, I said, okay, this is what my answer to her would be. But she had her own response at the back of her mind. So we discussed for a little bit, and it went our ways. And the day she called me, and she said, you know what? I knew you would say that, but my future was this. So I won. And she found the question, she said, okay, let's go to the figure. Anyway, that was her. So, her again skills paid a lot, actually. Paid a lot. Her sense of humor, was unimaginable. And, she'll tell you something in a very nice way, but you'll forever remember that, oh, I think I shouldn't wear that dress anymore because it didn't suit me. But I'm not sure what time you're done. Who come why I was in the way? Go away. Rest in peace, yes. You too, please. And as a sibling, in the African sense, I'll love to thank my siblings. But you know, Kundu, Tola, David, that unity of purpose that you demonstrated while you took care of one another, while you made everything that you were doing and concentrated to look after your sister. They can have shared, but I can't have shared, but they can't have shared.
Our next tribute is being shared by the nieces and nephews of our dearly departed, and to present this tribute is Mr. Bupet's son. I feel here from her the word number of people who had such personal relationships with our dear departed, including Father Kim, who sent quite an elaborate tribute. So to come and share this tribute with us. And it is
dry your eyes and remember me. Not as I am now, but as I used to be. Because I'll remember you all and look on with a smile. Understand in your hearts, I've only gone to rest a little more. As long as I have the love for each of you, I can live my life in my heart. I will now read Father Greening's tribute. Tribute to Mongya, Sunga, Kasase, Samana. Mongya, Musunga, Kasase, family, and all of you who are here crying for Mother Musunga. I'm sorry. I can't attend the funeral and speak to my little. However, as I lie on my bed, I often think of and wish for the courage and strength of all. Whenever I hear the call, Father Joe, I know it's somebody with a copper belt. For some reason, I was known in history as Father Joe. It was only when I came to the Santa, people started calling me Father Kini. Uga would call me across the far park with a unique, deep voice. Father Joe! And no matter who I was with or talking to, I had to turn around and meet this strong, powerful patriarch of the Kaba family. I was Father Joe because I first knew the family. The children were young, and Uga had a high school teacher at all sports. It was not my new best, as we spent a lot of time without being involved in or a member of any particular group, Uga was of central importance in the life of St. We found ourselves together again as we relocated to the Sartre. During her final illness and battle with colon cancer, she remained positive and strong. Her faith was unshakable. And she really could spoke of miracles. Unfortunately, for the past year, we were both isolated from each other because of our respective health issues. But we were in touch using text messages and WhatsApp. Sometimes, she would send me voice messages. These messages were filled with hope, but never passed. A wonderful sense of humor ran through them all. A few months ago, was described as side effects of the time. She told me her skin had become so dark, and she looked like a chocolate seller. I was really sorry that I couldn't go to the hospital to say goodbye. I would have assured her that the miracle she spoke about happened not as she expected, but in many unexpected ways. Even though you, her children, is far away, her great love for you was always a good child. There was a miracle. When her lovely house went down, it could have broken many other people. But not she remained strong and positive about rebuilding. For me, that was a miracle. There was another miracle in the way she mourned her dear husband, Mike. There was a miracle in the excitement she was barely able to conceal before setting off on one of her many journeys to visit her children and grandchildren in England and America. She had a wonderful sense of the power of God working in her life, lifting her out of disappointment. That was another miracle. Pain, whether it be a pain of the heart or physical pain from cancer, always leads us to the crossroads. It can make us bitter and angry, or we can become more gentle and godlike. Suffering and pain turn Uga into a better person. Often, when seeing her quietly pray in the church, I will be greatly uplifted. To you, three sons, Mongya, Musunga, and Kasase. And to you, her little baby, your mother has left you a great legacy. It's a legacy that doesn't have to be divided always. She has strength and tried to pass on to me what is important in life, and that is to believe in and hope the life of the world. As the ship is now, your vision becomes a little blurred. Believe that your mother, that one day you will be back with our heavenly, with you, with our Father in heaven. Hoping, may God reward you with eternal happiness as a great example you are to me and to many more. And finally, we have this question for our people. I write with great sadness over the unimaginable loss of all. I met her only over 18 years ago when her husband, Barbara, was running a sports shop, which was next to our business. After the death of Barbara, she took over the running of the business, and this is when we really got problems. As I can imagine, this loss of her husband devastated her. But even if her loss, she always carried herself with grace and didn't allow people to see her clearly. I was grateful and feel blessed that she trusted me enough to open up and allow me to see the vulnerable side of her. With God's grace, she managed to overcome the grief that she encountered without forgetting the love of her life. Our relationship continued to grow as possible. Our woman was beautiful, inside and out, and a wonderful friend to all who were lucky enough to hold this title. She would support and defend you with great conviction. Each one of her friends were able to feel special. She had such a nearness and aims for all of her friends. There was Lexen, there was Boy, Sevegi, and many others. And many. One of her beliefs was the importance of being authentic to people and saying what needed to be scarce without being clear. And this is what everybody has said today. I always admire how she would have done to force her opinions on anyone. She had a great sense of humor and was extremely witty. There was never a dull moment. She was also extremely well connected and always had an ear to the ground. Our woman always provide updates on current affairs. And I recall how once she sent news that like what one would now call alternative facts. When she realized, she quickly called back to say, and I quote, BNN Nigeria. BNN is Open News Network. Quickly recall that news. The facts have changed. Fortunately for both of us, I had not shared. I also recall during the dark moments after the death of my grandmother, Rana Wenya, this is when the old she was crying. So Rana Wenya, my child, they call Kunila, they call Kunila, Kalala. Finish it up later. Rana Wenya, they want to ask me. They want to ask me. That was not moving. When she was diagnosed with stage 4 cancer, I remember going to her house and finding my mother. She was inconsolable. We spoke to her about positive attitude, and she needed to change her behavior. She resolved right there and then that she would fight the cancer, and fighting she did. She fought with so much faith. She truly believed the words of Hebrews 11:22, which say, faith is the assurance of things hoped for, a conviction of things not seen. She believed in miracles. We all did. We honestly hoped that the miracle would happen. But unfortunately, God had another plan for her. She kept her humor throughout her illness, never complained, and was looking forward to the end of her treatment, so she went to the States. She had been married for my 17th birthday in August. But as God's word says, our plans are not his plans. Rahube was loving and genuine, a wonderful mother to her four children. Zonga, Mofia, Zonga, Kasase, and Papa. As well as her daughters-in-law and son-in-law. And Dr. Dr. Ma's grandmother to pay for her grandchildren. She laid a strong foundation for each one of us. A beautiful spirit moving on to them. I know she tried with all her heart to stay for all of you. To the children, you did everything that you could do in your power to support them. She's not knowing that she's very much known. I wish to thank David, who was always there for our Lord. I also wish to thank Malcolm, Bernadette, and the entire family who rallied around her. She was a true embodiment of her name, Mope, the gift to all of us that is to see her. I pray that she rests in peace and at the peace of God. That surpasses all understanding. Will rest on the children, the grandchildren, and the entire family. Go, 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 go. She refused to be called my friend and said you're too young. She was my big sister. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. It is well.
Thank you.
of take place at the back end of the church, and I would ask that the families are last as we proceed. She will be put to rest at Old Leopard Zoo Cemetery next to her dear husband, Mr. Michael Sonda Kapoor. Some of you may already know the location. Just in case you may not know, the gravesite is actually along the road that straddles between Leopard Zoo Road and Twin Park. There's a road that straddles in between, and if you're coming from Twin Park, it's about 3/4 of the way towards Leopard Zoo Road. It will be on your right, and it's unmistakable, and the preparations are there, the signage is clear. I would however like to advise all mourners that the route to the site from Leopard Zoo Road is not, the road is not in very good condition. It is advised that we actually approach the gravesite from Twin Palm Road. So it's strongly recommended that we go around and enter the road that travels through from Twin Palm Road. May I now invite the pallbearers to come. Thank you.
Yeah. May God sanctify your place of rest. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Because God has chosen to call our sister Bopekabwe from life to himself, we commit her body to the earth, for we are dust and to dust we shall return. But the Lord will change our mortal bodies to be like this to glory. So let us commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace and raise her up to the last day. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, members of the family are invited, those who have the energy to come and throw dust before we commence with the burying of the grave. Members of the family are invited, and then those who may not be able to can ask one of our gallant co-bearers to go with a shovel so that they can, those who are not able to.
Yeah, you can go with one at the same. Just a bit.
Itani buina corona kumanja osaiwa. Shaka Pangale, so is to Santi Kalungu in the Kunina. Thank you very much, choir. Ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the point of laying of wreaths. And the order, I will announce the order, and the persons, if they can then come forward and do so, so that we move through quickly. I should also mention at the beginning that we are doing this in categories. So apart from a few who are actually out of the country, we are not mentioning individual names, but clusters. So please, bear with me. So we'll start with the children. The four children who are here, come forward and lay their wreath, led by Mofia and Erin. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like amongst the children, someone to lay one for the grandchildren who could not be with us today. But you can ask to lay on behalf of the grandchildren. May I now invite the aunties led by Bamayoba and Ansoni, the aunties. Thank you. I would now like to invite the siblings and their spouses to come and place their wreaths. Can I also ask Wumba to come, who is going to place a wreath on behalf of Chola, who is not able to be with us. Invite the cousins, come forward. Linda Mkata to also lay a wreath on behalf of the cousin Mildred in the UK.
Go!
such as Mrs. Jere, those who fall in this category, the in-laws, please come forward. Ladies and gentlemen, before we get to friends and other family members, there's a special category of what we call special family relatives who will not be described as nephews or nieces or anything. People like me. It's our time. Friends and relatives who didn't fall in any of these categories to come forward. Ladies and gentlemen, our dearly departed at his house, she worked very closely with a number of workers who have been very loyal to her over many years. and they are with us, and I would like to invite those who are here to come and lay their wreath. The choir come forth and lay their wreath. The choir. Now invite our clergy, please, to come forth and also lay their wreath. Clergy. Ladies and gentlemen, I need to offer profuse apologies. I worried about the grandchildren overseas and forgot about the grandchildren in Zambia. So, if all those who are here, the grandchildren, if they can come forth and lay their wreaths before we come to closure. Ladies and gentlemen, I must apologize once again. In our quest to move forward, I completely forgot the representative of, as we say in Bemba, each tente. In UCZ, we say section. Do we have a representative of each tente? Or is it Dr. Mtati or someone? No. Yes. and gentlemen, I believe we have concluded this part of the program, and I would now like to invite Mr. David Busunga, the surviving brother to our dearly departed, to come and give us a vote of thanks.
Good afternoon, everyone. We praise the Lord for sparing us the rains today. I was very worried and kept praying that we do that just that, and I'm grateful that He has answered our prayers. Fellow mourners, allow me to begin by acknowledging and thanking our Heavenly Father and our Good Shepherd, Jesus Christ, for the life of Vanna Melchior, my dear sister, and the happy moments we share together. And I'm sure we'll all cherish the moments that we spend together for the rest of our life. I also wish to thank the church for the moral and spiritual support. We're truly grateful. To all friends and family, thank you so much for the love, the care, and support you rendered. I couldn't thank you enough. Thank you so much. And I think what you did just demonstrates just how much you love our sister. Thank you. I also wish to express my gratitude to Midlands Hospital. In particular, I wish to make special mention of Dr. Fukwe and Nurse Nangoma Mutudu, I hope I'm pronouncing it properly. And I would also wish to thank Dr. Kasonde, who was my sister's physician for a long time. I also wish to thank Sebele, Mrs. Jere, together with Mobile Medical Services, who provided the home care nursing support to my sister until she answered the Lord's call. It would be remiss of me if I didn't acknowledge the workers, or sorry, the domestic and farm helpers. I think there's Ms. Anguenia, Babanda, Mastakala, Herbert, Sophia, and Maria. You will note from the names that my sister, the deliberate policy, HR policy, of empowering our cousins from the pattern. Finally, I wish to thank the organizing committee under the able leadership of the chairman, Mr. Kasangan. I hope I'm not sounding like a political cadre. For a tireless effort and working behind the scenes to ensure that this ceremony runs smoothly. With those remarks, on Thursday, the day after my sister died, I woke up in the morning, you know, just thinking to myself how our first day in heaven must have been. And given her bubbly personality, I'm sure she kept everybody awake the whole night, bringing them to speed with the happenings on earth. And I'm sure spicing up the stories with a bit of exaggeration, especially with those relating to politics. And lastly, to the new chops, Wangwele, as she normally says to you, Robo, Dan, You really cared for your mom. You did everything you could. But she had to answer the Lord's call at the end of the day. With those remarks, I wish to hand back the floor to the master chairman. Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, through the death of your Son on the cross, you destroyed our death. Through his rest in the tomb, you allowed the graves of all who believe in you. And through his rising again, you restored us to eternal life. God of the living and the dead, accept our prayers. For those who have died in Christ and are buried with him in the hope of rising again. Since they were true to your name on earth, let them praise you forever in the joy of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Go in peace, O Christ.
Ladies and gentlemen, we come to the end of our session. For a few of us who are able to join us at the house with a few snacks for a limited number of people, those who are able to join us. Thank you very much.
Deixa eu cair, tô com...